Hey guys, today's video is going to be dedicated to tether lockers. You know, when you start one sticking, one of the things you'll quickly realize is that your tether is prone to falling down if you don't lock it into place somehow in the middle of your moves. And so you see this question a lot on the boards is, how to keep my tether from falling down? What's the most popular ways to do it? Well, we're going to go over four or five of the most popular ways today, and we're going to cover basically the way, the order that most people progress through their one sticking adventure, right? And a lot of people start off with just a basic old gear tie. And then a lot of times people will use a rubber fender washer. We're going to go over the pros and cons of each of these. One of the more intriguing ways that I saw and learned how to do early on was an elastic shock cord. And this has got a lot of merit to it. We'll go over that. And of course, you'll see every once in a while somebody will just suggest just a good old clothespin, right? Probably costs a penny or so right there. And then once you kind of progress and get into the fancy stuff, you know, this is innovating the outdoors. This is the own tether locker. It's actually what I use personally right now. It's got a lot of merit to it. We'll discuss this one in detail. And then I get the privilege of introducing a brand new product to you. Actually, it is from Innovating the Outdoors, and we're going to go over that at the very end of this video. I think it's probably going to be the biggest hit. It's going to be my favorite. It's what I'm looking forward to moving to, and we'll show you that at the end. So stick around, come back and watch, and we'll show you all the pros and cons of each of these and why you should be using one of them in your one sticking endeavors. Okay guys, so here we are. This is the gear tie, right? This is what it seems like just about everybody starts with, at least they used to in the past. Now people have been doing this for a long time, and we kind of learned it may not necessarily be the best things. What all of us old timers kind of started off with. And you know, a gear tie is going to keep your tether from falling down while you're making a move, right? It's not coming down. That is a pro. It's definitely staying in place. Well, what's the con? Well, the climb of shame back up, because when you put your Dynaglide here and you rappel down and you have not undid that little part right there, guess what? That Dynaglide is not pulling that tether down, right? That's what we call the climb of shame. You are going back up to undo this gear tie so that you can then rappel down for a second time, and now you'll be able to pull your tether down, right? So the con is there will be a time that you will forget to undo your gear tie at some point in your one sticking career. It's like this, you know, I've said it before. If you haven't missed a turkey if you're a turkey hunter and you've never missed a turkey, guess what that tells me? You haven't turkey hunted long enough, right? It's what all turkey hunters say. And I hunted for years without missing a turkey, and I thought, how can you miss a turkey? Well, there came a day. And it's like that, you know. If you haven't missed a turkey, you just haven't turkey hunted long enough. Well, if you haven't one-sticked and used a gear tie and haven't forgot to undo it, well, you just haven't one-sticked long enough, because there will be a day you will forget to undo this gear tie and you will have to climb back up. So everybody does it. Get used to it. If you're using a gear tie, it will happen at some point. That's the con to it, right? Hey guys, here's the rubber fender washer. You can buy this at any Ace Hardware store. Probably a quarter, I think, is what I paid for these. It's got about a 3/16 or a quarter inch inside diameter for the hole. And you can see it will hold it up and keep it from falling, right? The good thing, that's kind of a pro. I'm going to show you that if I clip on the Dynaglide here behind it, if I forget to remove it, it will pull right off and pull through, so you're able to retrieve your rappel rope. So that's another plus. Here's what, and I use this several times over the last year or so. Here's the kind of the con to me was, as I moved up, I would have to push this back feet. You can see I'm having a little bit of a difficult time moving it around, and every time I'd make a move, I'd have to pull this thing out, climb up with it, retighten it, slide that up. It's just a little bit of a hassle, right? But for a quarter, I don't know, I can't remember, it was something like that at Ace Hardware. A quarter, 50 cents, it's not a bad solution, right? And like we just showed you, it will pull free if you happen to forget to remove it and you don't have to do the climb of shame, right? It's just a hassle to maneuver and kind of push it back through the quick link as you're making your moves. Just like I'm having to struggle with it just a little bit. So, it's not a bad solution though. For a cheap offering. It will hold it. Not a bad offering at all. Okay guys, the good old clothespin. Probably 3 cents or something like that. And the nice thing about it is you can undo it, put it back on. It's gonna hold it and keep it from falling down. The thing is you gotta, you know, as you're maneuvering up and down the tree, remembering what to do with this, you gotta, you know, clip it on you or something the whole time you're moving up and down. But, you know, and this doesn't really seem, I guess you can buy bigger clothespins. This looks like it's about to come apart on, this is a 9mm CIV rope right here. But probably not the most durable, but you do see it offered from time to time as a solution. So I wanted to show you and not be remiss and not even point it out. But, you know, I'm not the craziest about the clothespin. Okay, this is about a 6-inch piece of elastic shock cord that I just tied together here. And actually, believe it or not, this is one of my favorite methods. And all I did was I just ran it through a couple times. You can see the pro is it will hold, it'll work. It's a little more involved to kind of get it on there and make it work and get it tight. You probably could, let me go ahead and, I don't know if I ever tried to, yep, it will pull through. I don't think I ever forgot to do it while I was using this method. It will pull through fairly easy and it will hold it in place. That shock cord, I ordered it from Amazon. I don't know, it came in foot section, 2 foot section. It was a dollar or two. It's not very expensive either. I will tell you this though, is I use this several times, and when you get done at the end of your hunt, and you stick this in your pocket or wherever, that's typically what I would do. Stick it in my pocket, and then the next time you go hunt, you're like, well, where's that shock cord? Ah, it's in my hunting pants, the other hunting pants or whatever. So I ended up making about 5 of these because I had them scattered everywhere throughout all my hunting stuff. Some of them were in the car, some of them were in my fanny pack, some of them were in a backpack, some of them were in hunting clothes, jacket. It just seems like every time you take one of these on and off that you end up misplacing it somewhere along the way. So, but it will work. Okay guys, this is the Ohm Tether Locker from Innovating the Outdoors. And Kyle Skelly makes these up by hand. It's actually a 3D printed piece right here. He sells it currently in an 8mm ohm or a 9. Right here we've got Restech in an 8mm, and so this is a corresponding 8mm. The nice thing with this Amsteel tag on the end, all you have to do is girth hitch it right behind your scaffold knot. It makes it big enough you can just run the ohm right through there. And then so what you do is where you would normally clip on right behind the scaffold knot to pull this free, well, that's what this is for. So you're actually putting it right where the same exact pull point, the best pull point would be to retrieve your rappel rope. And then you've got this nice expanse of Amsteel here that gives you the freedom and the flexibility to clip on right behind there, and there you go. You're locked on. It's not going to slip. It's not going to fall. And here's the cool thing about it. see this little spot right here that Kyle builds in here, this little loop? Well, that loop is made specifically to clip your amp, your down glide onto. So take your mini carabiner and clip it right there. And what that does is, now if you've done that, you're probably going to remember that, well, it'll make it just easy, go ahead and unclip now before I rappel down, right? But let's say you do forget, and you've got your own tether locker there, and you've rappelled down, and you're like, crap, I forgot to remove the ohm before I rappel down. Well, grab it and pull down, and now you can just pull, okay? So the great thing, that was a solution that Kyle offered the industry and us one stickers, is that if you forget to remove your tether locker, it really doesn't matter, because he gave us this spot here to clip our mini carabiner right into. And that will not only break the ohm free, then you can use it to retrieve your rope. So Kyle and I spent some time going back and forth, and I actually asked him, why do you make your amsteel so long? And at first he told me, he goes, well, that's to get to the proper buries, the dimensions I need, so that you can give it, you know, the hundreds of pounds of force it takes to break this free sometimes. And, you know, sometimes we're yanking, I mean, hard on these things, and he doesn't want the buries coming out. So that was the reason why. He looked at making this shorter, and about the time we were having that discussion, I figured out that, you know what, the great thing about this, having this length of his tail here, is I can actually pull that back to the end of the tail, just like that. Now I've got the freedom to go up, and that's what I need to make my move, and then slide it back up. So I actually like this long tail here, so that I can use it to pull down, expand, move however I want to, and then slide it back up. This has become my go-to tether locker here. Guys, you can tell it is just a nice little offering, nice solution that Kyle has given us in the industry here. And it is on all of my rappel ropes now. And so anyway, that's the ohm tether locker. In fact, Kyle did us one better. He gave us this next one we're excited about. And let me open the package, and I'm gonna show you what this next one's about. Okay, guys, I just hung this up and attached this, and it was funny, even Gabe goes, is that it? It looks like the exact same thing. Well, very close, except for it is a brand new ohm that Kyle just came out with, and here's the cool thing. Yeah, it does look very similar, right? Except for focus in here and watch this. It is a flexible, rubberized ohm. So this one ohm now can handle from 8 to 10, and Kyle is testing it on 11 millimeter rope, but it will run the gamut. And the nice thing with it being with rubber is it's not so hard to, sometimes with the old one, it was hard to snap on at different times, right? And you had to order an 8 one, and you notice I've swapped back and forth between Restec and CIV here. I have some 8 millimeter ropes, I have some 9 millimeter ropes. This one flexible ohm covers the gamut. It'll handle all your rope needs. So I'm really excited. I mean, that's a very snug fit, but it was not hard to get on at all. And again, we got the same concept of Kyle built in a spot here that you can clip your mini carabiner on your pull down rope. And look, it comes down super easy, and you can retrieve your rappel rope like that. But I believe Kyle told me this one's gonna be $14 on the website, available almost any day now. But again, this concept of the ohm tether locker is a really nice, I love that flexible rubber ohm. And you can, again, you can just slide it back down. Move up. Slide it into place, but then when it comes time, come down, pulls off super easy, retrieve your rappel rope. So guys, I hope that gives you some a lot of things to consider when you're looking at tether lockers. That's about everything that I know about. I can tell you that this is absolutely the product of my choice right here, is the Ohm tether locker, and especially this brand new flexible rubber one. So check out innovatingtheoutdoors.com and get yours. I think it's $14. So anyway, if you have any questions, drop them in the comments. We'll see you next video.